Hello friends, Namaskar. In today's video, I am going to discuss with you a very important concept of Dispute Resolution Panel. In this video, we will see what is DRP, when a person can approach to DRP, what is the approach of the DRP, what basically DRP does during the course of proceeding before it, how an assessee's matter is finally concluded by the DRP, and if the assessee is not agreeing with the DRP's directions, then what is the further remedial course available to him. So through this video, I'll try to take you through all such points in a summarized manner. So the first point which we should see is why DRP? What is the need of dispute resolution panel? Let me put it up in this particular term. The dispute resolution panel is an alternative dispute mechanism set up with a view to minimize the tax disputes relating to taxation of international transactions and taxation of non-resident. What do I mean to say? That in certain assessees, not in the case of all assessees, the assessees where the international transactions are involved, the assessees where the taxation of non-resident is involved, in those cases only, the DRP works as an alternative dispute mechanism. To put it in simple terms, I may say, rather than there being an assessment order directly on the assessee, the approach which is adopted in these two kind of cases by the Government of India is such that the AO will present you, he will give you a draft assessment order in your assessments case. You will see that whether you are agreeing with the draft assessment order or not, and if you don't agree with the draft assessment order which the AO will provide to you, then you have to approach to the dispute resolution panel. Now, what is the sense of dispute resolution panel being there? That dispute resolution panel will see that what are the objections which you are filing before it against the draft order of the AO. Then accordingly, it will issue the necessary direction which it wants that the AO should modify his order accordingly. And probably this is why this particular thing is understood to be an alternative dispute mechanism. Let me put it the second para also before you. This contains a process of inviting objections to the draft assessment order, which provides an opportunity to the assessee to raise objections, if any, at an early date and helps in giving finality to the assessment order. Now, let me also put up before you what is DRP. We have understood the background in which the DRP is framed. But the DRP basically means a collegium which is comprising of three principal commissioners or commissioners of income tax constituted by the Central Board of Direct Taxes. It means that Central Board of Direct Taxes will determine certain dispute resolution panels. Those dispute resolution panels will comprise of a collegium kind of activity in which the three principal commissioners or commissioners of income tax would be the sitting members of the DRP. Next question is, whose case may be referred to the DRP? This is a very important question to understand, that only an eligible case will refer to the DRP. Now, who is an eligible assessee? Any person in whose case the variation referred to in subsection 1 arises as a consequences of the order of transfer pricing officer passed under subsection 3 of section 92CA, and any non-resident, very important term, not being a company or any foreign company with effect from 1st of April 2020. This second point is very important because lot of non-residents, my dear friend, are getting affected through this particular process. Rather, they are not in knowledge of this, that AO might have opened up an assessment against them and now he is giving them the draft order. So they are thinking of filing an appeal before CIT appeal. This is not the correct approach. Wherever in your case, a draft assessment order is passed by the AO with reference to section 144C, read with section maybe 143.3 or 144, then you have an option to approach to the DRP if you are filing an objection to the assessment order which the AO has given you in form of a draft order. If, however, you are agreeing with the draft order, there is no need to go and file objection before DRP. However, if you feel that you are not satisfied with the draft order which the AO is providing to you, then you have to certainly think of claiming the necessary relief through DRP. Now, let me put up before you what is the procedure before DRP. So, as I said that the non-residents are one of the big category who are presently facing the DRP related aspects, that they are probably not aware that the AO is giving them the draft order what to do next. So if they are agreeing, as I said, they have to pay the tax or they have to ultimately settle at that particular case. And if they are not agreeing to, then they have to approach to the DRP. So if in the case of an eligible assessee, the AO will prepare a draft assessment order and communicate it to the assessee. The assessee on receipt of such order within 30 days of the receipt of order, either he will file his acceptance of the variations to the AO or he will file his objections to such variation with the DRP as well as to the AO. So what you are supposed to do, either you agree with the AO regarding the draft order, or if you disagree, then you have to file your objections to both, that is to the DRP as well as to the AO. Now I am further continuing the procedure to say that if no objections are received by the DRP, say for an example in your case, a draft order is made by the AO because you are a person who has indulged into international transaction, or who is a non-resident in whose case the assessment order, that is draft assessment order, is made by the AO, and or maybe you are a foreign company. Now what is happening in your particular case, if you have not objected to the DRP within 30 days of the receipt of order, what the AO will do, he will complete the assessment. He will complete the assessment on the basis of draft order. So as most of the people like non-resident in whose case draft order is being made are approaching either to the CIT appeal, which is not the right case. If they are not objecting, then the AO will finalize his order. That is a very important point to be noted. And in the case of acceptance of order by the assessee or on non-filing of the objection before DRP by the assessee, within 30 days of the receipt of draft order, what the AO will do, AO shall within 1 month from the end of the month in which such acceptance is received or no objection is filed, pass an assessment order. So what the AO will do, either you are a mute, that is you are not speaking regarding against the draft order, or you are not filing any objections, or you have given acceptance. What the AO will do, AO will finally converting his draft order into a final order. Again, on the procedure side, I may further say, where the objections are filed before the DRP, it shall issue necessary directions to the AO to enable him to complete the assessment. And this is a very important task where, let's assume you have filed an objection before DRP. What DRP will do? DRP is bound to issue necessary directions to the AO for completing the assessment to which you have objected. However, DRP before issuing any direction, consider the following. What DRP will take care about? It will take care about the draft order. It will also take care about the objections which you are filing as an assessee. It will also consider report of AO evaluation officer, transfer pricing officer, if any, filed with it, records which are relating to the draft order, evidences which are collected by it, or the result of enquiry which is made by it. Now I am going to discuss a very important ultimate understanding that what is the ultimate power of the DRP, my dear friends. Ultimately, what the DRP shall do after hearing your case, after looking into the records, it may either confirm or it may reduce or it may enhance the variation proposed in the draft order. So finally, what DRP shall do, that whatever additions are proposed by the AO, DRP will have the power to confirm them or to ask the AO to reduce them, or it may also ask the AO to enhance them. So these are three variations which may happen in response to the DRP proceedings. Now, an important question which we have to understand here is whether hearing the assessee is necessary for the DRP. If the DRP issues directions which are prejudicial to the assessee or in the interest of the revenue, opportunity of being heard to the assessee is a must. Very important point, sir. If DRP is not agreeing to your objections, then before not agreeing to your objections, it has to give you an opportunity of being heard. Now, a very million-dollar question which I would like to add here, no doubt that an assessee may present himself before the DRP on his own. But I certainly suggest that you should avail the services of a consultant, a chartered accountant, a tax consultant, a tax advocate, who can put up your case based on the facts and circumstances in a best manner before the DRP for your sake. Now, what is the time limit of issue of directions by the DRP? The law says, this is Section 144C of Income Tax Act, which I am discussing here. No directions shall be issued by the DRP after 9 months from the end of the month in which the draft order was forwarded to the assessee. So it means whenever you received a draft order, within 9 months from the end of the month of such draft order being forwarded to you, the DRP shall finalize its hearing and it will issue the final directions to the EU. One more point which we need to understand, that what is the consequence of the order of DRP? Very important point to be noted here, my dear friends, is on receipt of draft order, the EO shall, so he has no may here, he shall, in conformity with the directions, complete the assessment within 1 month from the end of the month in which the directions are received. So no if, no but, EO has to accept all those directions of the DRP as such, and therefore he has to finally pass an assessment order. So the crux which we can draw here off is that if you are not satisfied with the draft order of the EO, in your case, you being a foreign company, you being a non-resident, you being a person who has entered into certain international transaction, and in your case, a draft order was proposed by the EO, and you further moved into DRP. Now DRP, after listening to you, after maybe understanding the assessee's case before EO, will issue the final directions. And those directions are very importantly, they are binding on the EO to be followed. So what you are seeking here, if you compare the CIT appeal, there the appellate time is usually more than this 9 months which I have discussed with you. Secondly, rather than CIT appeal, which is the alone CIT level person, here the three CITs are sitting who will be deciding the matter of yours by a majority. And it is the presumption of the law that since they are more experienced person, so they may be able to decide your case in a precise understanding. That is the crux of the DRP proceeding as a whole. Now, what if the assessee is not satisfied with the DRP directions? This is another important point. Suppose you are not agreeing to even DRP's directions, or the DRP has simply agreed to whatever variations are proposed by the EO, then what you will do? The assessee has to wait till the order of the EO based on the DRP direction is passed, and then he may file an appeal before the Income Tax Appellate Tribunal within 60 days of the receipt of assessment order. So what you are supposed to do, you can't as such file appeal against DRP direction. You have to wait for the EO to finally pass his order, finally convert his draft order into a final order based on the DRP direction. And then if you are not satisfied with that order, then you will file an appeal not before CIT appeal, but directly before ITAT. Now, some friends of mine would be asking me, Bhatiaji, if you can also tell us which are the locations at which DRP offices are situated. Presently, my dear friends, in my understanding, Mumbai, New Delhi and Bangalore are three locations where DRP offices are situated. So, the respective jurisdiction you can find online, that which state will be covered into which particular region, maybe Mumbai, New Delhi, Bangalore, and accordingly you have to approach to the DRP of the respective area. You would also be interesting in knowing which form to be filled before DRP. So a form 35A is prescribed in this manner. I could not find it online as such as on date. It may be available online also. This form 35A will be submitted along with facts which you have submitted to the EO, the grounds of the objection, the legal arguments which you want to put up, the case laws which on which you are seeking a relief, the legal arguments of the case, factual and legal arguments, etc. So all these things you have to put up along with your application for submission before DRP. So DRP, after considering all such particular application which is made in the prescribed form along with the annexures thereto, will finally issue the directions as I have discussed with you. So my dear friends, the purpose of this particular video is to make a kind of awareness amongst the non-resident who may not be aware about the DRP proceedings as on date, but I hope this video will serve the purpose and will help you to seek the necessary remedy in a proper manner through the DRP forum. Thank you very much for listening to me. I hope I'll be able to contribute more to you through the answer to your particular questions. Thank you very much for being with me. Jai Hind.